couple ways to get to the quarterback.
Oh.
And they are in on Peterson.
Bullshit.
Sorry, bro. This is too much for me to handle.
And what a run by Abe.
Not slowing down, is he? Still the best highlight film I've ever seen of a college football player when he came out of Oklahoma. And that opportunity.
And Wallace brought down after picking up 14 on the play.
Yeah, I don't know why my defense can't block the fucking pass.
And a lot of that has to do with the passing game. Bridgewater's been on the mark to this point.
He has. He's one of the better throwers.
That's all they've been fucking doing. I can't stop.
Give him time like he's had here so far today. He is going to put it right on target.
Peterson's going to secure the handoff.
Okay, just show that you're
running back that time. He makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Peterson's taking the handoff. Mebane's all over that offense and brings him down.
You got to be smart on the defensive side now here, third and long. Be a little careful. Maybe give up a short pass or a short run. And if they throw it short, make sure you come up and make the...
Vikings are at the line, facing third down, which was not an issue for them last week as they converted a number of times in crucial situations. Scanning the field, KJ Wright has the sack.
Yeah, you got a shitty-ass connection.
Do I?
Well, you just get tired.
Yeah, man, it's like breaking up bad.
At the quarterback in passing situations. So this time the defensive coordinator sends the blitz, and they...
I hear the feedback from your TV or whatever it is I'm hearing from. It sounds like I'm a robot.
I want to do something real quick there. Settings. I'll turn the Wi-Fi off on my phone, see if that works.
They are up for it. They get to the QB and get a sack.
The fuck was that all about?
Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. The fumble by the kick return team and look out.
Well, got the ball.
The Vikings defense comes
back.
They
got the ball.
Did not look so good that last series, giving up the touchdown.
You know the coaches are upset. My gosh, they ran some of the most elementary defenses that you can run, and they had mistakes by the defensive players. And they coached them up on the sidelines. We'll see if we see different results.
That's reception number two for him.
The Seahawks did a good job there on first down. That pass picks up some good solid yards. Now second and short. Much easier to call those kind of plays.
Second down, three for the first. That's a gain of seven.
Get up. There you go.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
The Seahawks are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. Lynch looking for a lane.
That fast stretch
He's
sounds like a great
about 4 yards to carry.
Oh, watch that shit.
Lynch is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers,
fuck.
And what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
Hit 9 yard rush.
An extra tight end on the field for this one. Tebow's got a scramble. Moves very nearly to the pick.
I'm not used to it.
And now they'll try over again on second down.
Left-handed quarterback.
The Vikings lined up in the nickel from the gun.
It's weird.
I used to got Tim Tebow with her.
Yeah.
Because
Russell Wilson, he's out for 4 weeks.
Play this cover three
sucks,
defense. Just kind of sit back there and
ball,
try to get
play,
a big
right?
play.
Yeah.
That is great. The problem is you give up all these short plays. How about that throw by the quarterback on that slant pattern at times?
Right, that's good.
Tebow's completely completion percentage, 60% on the day.
He still got Marshawn Lynch, right, man? I rely on him.
Yeah, that's all I've been doing.
That's what I'm having to do. I'm having to rely on my passing game a lot. But still, Michael Tolbert stepped up big time, man. My rushing game is seriously badass. I just got done doing 518 yards rushing.
He just gets it done for sheer
first down.
They were ready for that one.
Viking defense is so fast and so powerful. That time on the run play, they just overpower the offensive line. They tackle.
I hear everything I'm saying back, like after 10 seconds.
Second down and 13.
That sounds like a robot.
It's Jermaine Curse coming down with it.
Yeah, just now. I just route that time was run to
perfection by the receiver. He made such a sharp cut. He gives himself some space from the defender, and the quarterback takes the football right
outside. Catch it.
Just short of that
nice.
Third and two. They go screen with Lynch.
Good screen play. Yeah.
The first down is picked up. The offense picks up another first down and extends this drive.
Oh, he's one of their favorite run, baby, run. Oh, yeah. Offensive line.
They are dominating the defense right now. Marshawn
damn, Lynch man, next week, who you know you play next week?
Hand off. Keeps his legs moving. That's a gain of 10. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day. Lynch is a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down.
Oh, stepped on his ass. He said, move, bitch. 50 yards rushing on the day already. Nice. And you know you want to do that stretch.
No doubt he was going to hold on to that.
You can tell the linebacker's tight as fuck.
Yeah, right?
Coleman.
Oh, never mind. He's open. Look how tired they are, man. They're slow as fuck.
Quarterback, I'll tell you that. I love
they can't even tackle. They're so tired.
And just root your guy on and watch him score a touchdown. Pretty exciting.
That's what you need to do. Next possession, man. Just pound it. Just keep running the fuck out of them, man.
The Vikings
yeah,
are ready
just
to
run the hell
the
out of them next half. If they're getting tired on that drive right there like that, man, yeah, you'll murder them in the fourth quarter.
Fields the football at the
just keep running the fuck out of them.
Tackle yeah. Just past
switch
the
20 that fullback halfback, fullback halfback.
The Seahawks defense got tested on that last drive, but eventually it led to a punt.
Yeah, it was an awesome job by the defense. They really did a lot of things correct. They hustled. They played hard. That is the cornerstone to any good defense.
First down at the 22. Peterson's tackled down at the 22.
See with me, I still
he's
got Cam.
About 3 yards to carry on the
back. We've been doing most of the rushing.
Yeah.
Ever since my running game's gone out, my coach is like, the coach's suggestions and whatnot has changed a lot.
Packing the line of scrimmage.
It's a lot like Wildcat offense.
Pulls it in. They'll mark him at the 29. The Vikings trail right now, but the passing game has been strong. Bridgewater's doing what he can to keep them in the game.
Well, they are losing, but you cannot blame the offense.
I heard
the offensive
that
line doing a good job giving the quarterback time, and the offensive coordinator, he's sitting over there going, he doesn't know which play to call because everything is working in the passing game.
There we go.
Yeah, watch Bridgewater, man. He's a game manager.
What?
Yeah, I play that zone.
Bullshit.
That's what all happens right. When you try to guess the snap count.
Oh, they're going back against them.
Oh, listen to that. Listen to it.
What? Defense?
Yeah.
How?
The Seahawks with a nickel look here on defense. Now first and 10. Cliff Avril brings down the quarterback.
I don't know how the fuck that happened, though.
Every defense is looking for somebody to hit the quarterback, and the best person to do it
nice.
Is the defensive end. What a good job that time by him.
Nice.
Second down now.
Dude, right there's boss, man.
Well, every defense is looking for somebody to sack the quarterback, and that time the speed of the defensive
end
gets around
good.
The tackle and gets the sack.
That's two sacks right there, man. He just had an amazing game.
On that last play, third down coming up.
Wow.
Oh, shit.
Johnson's got the grab on
Gosh.
The touchdown. That's his fifth catch of the day.
Told you, man, you gotta watch Bridgewater.
The Vikings have done a fantastic job here of getting the football to one of their key targets. Johnson's been a menace out there in the secondary with huge first half totals.
He does have a lot of talent. That's why they try to get the football to him. But the play design by the offensive coordinator.
He's really underrated, man. Bridgewater's pretty fucking good. You gotta watch him.
I need to put more people over there with him.
Come back to the field. We're looking at a defense trying to maintain a lead going into the break. Second down, two to go.
It's on blitz, man.
Incomplete.
Put that pressure on him, but put that zone out there to get that pick. You got a good man to man on the outside, don't you?
Third down now. The Seahawks defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Bridgewater's back in shotgun formation.
That's
gonna bring
man.
Up fourth down.
Interesting situation right here, isn't it, Jim? Fourth and short near midfield.
Nice.
It's in the first half. Do you go for it to try to get momentum back on your side, or do you punt it away? Me, I would punt it. We'll see what the coach does.
Hell yeah, man.
And he punts it, and it's going to sail out of bounds. Trying to play kick away from that dangerous returner. And Marshawn Lynch heading back onto the field. It's been an excellent showing for him so far. It's his running that's really propelled his team to the lead.
You know, I don't think we're surprised, though, because when we met with the coaches and watched practice, it was all about the run.
Yep.
And, man, they carried everything over into the game. Really, the
Damn, they put four out.
The Vikings defense now is going to go nickel. Hand off.
They put four deep, too. That's the funny thing.
The Vikings call the timeout. They're first.
Damn.
I don't want to fucking
Everybody's
run.
Everybody's back out on the field
they
now after
call
that
timeout.
Defensive timeout. Third there. Down.
You know you're going to have to throw it. Yeah, play action.
The Seahawks get a first down. The Seahawks will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down.
X. Oh, nice.
First down here. The Seahawks line up. Split backfield. Tebow's going to take it from the gun.
So long. There you go. Holmes.
God, my guy was just
Floyd with the sack.
Moving
well,
all fucking
to the
weird.
On first down. Sets up second and long. Tebow standing back in the shotgun ready for the snap.
Oh my god, he's not throwing the ball.
The Vikings, one timeout remaining.
Banger deep.
Following that timeout, defense back out on the field.
Yeah, this is a
run the ball, man. Just run the ball. Go into the half.
The Seahawks come out. Jumbo package on the field. The Vikings defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. After that timeout by the defense, play is ready to resume. Patterson's got it now. He'll pick up seven this time. The Seahawks defense, Bill, where are they right now mentally after the last time giving up a couple of first downs, but in the end forcing the punts?
They feel great. And I'll give a lot of credit to the coaches on the sideline.
Yeah, like two plays.
And the players took advantage of it.
Damn.
And that will close out the first half from the Twin Cities. We'll step away for halftime and be back to Minneapolis in just a moment for the beginning of the third quarter.
Thanks, Jim, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get to it. The Vikings secondary has done a good job to slow down the passing game so far. The Seahawks really did a good job in that area last week, but yardage-wise, not making the same kind of impression in today's game.
That return is good for about 22.
The fuck?
The Vikings offense trots out onto the field looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency.
You there?
On the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think they need to try a few different ones here in the second half.
Peterson, solo, back set.
Because I had a buzz.
The Vikings trail right now, and you wonder how much the running game stays a part of the game plan. Peterson's been stopped from the first quarter.
Running game has no chance. That's obvious. We've seen it here today, and it's time for this offense to open it up. Quit trying to run the football and throw it down the field.
Murdered him, man. Second, 14, 4 yard loss. Guys.
Second down. Stop the run, man. Way to go. Peterson.
That's what they're going to try to do, you guys. You got to be careful, man.
Last week, you would think this team would build on that running attack, but that has not been the case today.
Yeah, so much has to click for
your man to man's pretty good, man. I love the break. You see it a lot.
To block well, but you also need tight ends and the wide receivers to get it done. I think that's why they have struggled here today.
The Vikings need to get to the 35 to pick up a first.
Third and 13.
Yeah.
And that's a defense that doesn't yield a whole lot. They didn't in the first half. And now same story here in the third quarter, Phil, especially on third down.
Yeah, been a good job. They've done a good job all day long on third down, Jim. But the defensive coordinator, let's give him some credit. It takes talent and good coaching to make it work on the field. And right now they're getting some good coaching.
Baldwin's taken down at the 26. And a run back of about 10. The Seahawks take the field here in the second half, looking to extend their lead in this one, partner.
Yeah, you know what you do? It's halftime is over. You come out here, you're not sure what the new game plan is going to be, but feel your way into the game. Don't take a chance early and turn the football over. The Vikings defensive coordinator, my gosh, he is one happy guy. Anytime you get in the backfield and stop a runner and make him lose yards, that's some good stuff.
Loss of a couple that time. Tebow's got it in the gun. Jimmy Graham with the grab. Graham's taken down at the 33.
The drag route is a huge part of every offense now in the NFL. It's where the receiver starts on one side of the football, goes across the field, looking for those spots where he can catch
it. Nice, man. He could have got that first down there.
At the right time, right on target. Good yardage, just short of the first down.
Tebow's completion percentage.
God, that was touchy. Joystick.
Well, the defense, they give them a first down there. They're behind. They just can't sit back there and keep bending. You got to take some chances. Go on the offensive.
Lynch has got it on the handoff. Griffin's there to take him down.
First down,
the Seahawks haven't had the same type of effort
so
on the
fast,
ground this week.
Fucking control
Lynch
him.
Has been unable to find the same type of running room he had last week, Phil.
Yeah, listen, this defense did a tremendous job scouting this offense, and they knew it. They wanted to stop the running game. They have done it. Now the offense
send the fullback in the middle.
And that gains a few.
Lynch is never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Third and five. Throws the pass. Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains. That's another reception giving it two.
The Seahawks offense, they know it's more than just about their defense. The offense did a good job that time picking up the first down. That's what you want to do. You got a small lead in the second half. Keep
this was
one
of two, by the way.
Lynch is tackled down at the 32.
Yeah, he was, I saw that.
He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
This offense counts on
this. It's okay, man. That defense gets tired.
He delivers. The top rusher in the NFL once again. Great tackles. Makes a beautiful run.
They get tired, man. Nice run.
The Seahawks from the 32. Takes it from the strong eye. He's tackled right at the 24.
On the next drive, man, they'll come out pretty weak.
Always good to have these types of runs.
Especially if your defense got out there and stopped 3-0 again. Yeah, that's pretty nice.
It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to.
Look at the runs,
and also,
man. I'll tell you, man, they're slowing down. They're getting slower.
The Seahawks have it at the 24. Shakes off the tackle. That's it. Sweet.
Well, you get a couple first downs on a drive. It just, of course, it makes you feel good about what you're doing. It loosens up the offensive play caller, and there's nothing like dictating to the defense.
Nice. Bring
that tackle. All by himself in the backfield for this snap. Wilson with the reception. Wilson's tackled down at the 15.
The Vikings defensive coordinator made the right call that time.
You can attack the middle all day now because those Seahawks, nobody was even touched them, guarding them there in the middle.
Yeah. Second and eight.
If you wear out the D like that, just running up and down all the time. It's nice, man. Like the linebackers run, like motherfucker. They're going to be slow, man. They're just not going to be there.
Hey, you get in position like this, you can knock it down.
You had your tight end and your halfback wide open. I'm serious, you could throw in the center all day, man.
It's a catch by Richardson. And Richardson's got the first as he's brought down.
And did that curl flat, did that route in the middle.
First down by the offense in the red zone. And, you know, if you're on the defensive side, you don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive.
Lock goes wide open for the touchdown.
Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
I'm your offensive coordinator. I'm watching the game with Red right now.
Yeah, you're a little late.
I'm seeing this shit. Yeah, I know. When I see that, you got the touchdown and all that. Sucks about the delay. The next job, man, I keep doing that, man. Run it, and then do like play action pass up the center of the field.
For the touchdown.
Galloping into the end zone
for the 23rd time this year. And they continue to take that game plan that worked so well in the first half and do it here midway through the third quarter with another touchdown, Phil.
So my answer is, what's the defense thinking? My gosh, the game plan didn't change on the
offensive line.
That
defensive line is too, man. Your O-line's murdered.
You have to get on that sideline and figure out what you want to do.
He's got a chance to return this one.
Your halfback crew, your rushing crew, and everything. Man, I don't see how you can't just run for first down every time.
The Vikings offense comes back onto the field. Let's see if they can move the chains this time because the last possession was ugly. They weren't out there very long.
Jim, you know how I think in situations like this, I think it's
I'd say that'd be our strategy. Go ahead and rush for two first downs.
Defense off guard. So you
switch
can get
up, play action pass,
on your side
right
get
up the center of the field.
Cliff brings down the quarterback.
Man, this defensive end, Jim, he is some talent. That time, good job, makes the move, shows the speed.
Nice sack, man. Damn, that's what, 3-4 sacks for him? Damn. Ain't about to have a fucking record game.
It's now second down.
How many? What's the most sacks
the
in one game?
All bunched up here as they get set at the line.
What's that? Five or so?
middle of the field. And
I have no idea how that was not a pass interference.
Quarterbacks love to see a receiver have this type of play. Even though he doesn't make the catch, the effort is outstanding, and he's given everything he has to make that catch.
Wow.
Third and long. He'll throw it over
hey,
the middle.
Hey, man, better be glad they get called.
Down. Yeah, that's going to bring up fourth down.
Man,
good job by the defense. Staying in the right spots. They give up the short pass. They make the tackle. And now we have fourth down.
They got him, man. They're stuffing him at the line and shit, man. Did you put press on him?
Yep.
Baldwin's going to take this one from the 16.
They're killing him, man.
And the tackle is made at the 35-yard line.
Excellent blocking that time by the punt return team.
I did not
They're
know where
engaged.
I wanted to go.
The defenders cannot get away.
Right, you just call the ball. You're running it.
To have that time to make the right decision.
Yeah, I see what's up. They're coming both sides.
First down at the 35.
Definitely got blocked three tackles, you know.
He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Well, not many yards you get there on that play, but it doesn't matter. What a day and what a job this running back has done here.
Go ahead, just keep running it, man. Get that first down.
He's up I should have cut inside.
So far on the day. This
offense
yards.
Relies on this running back as much as any offense in the NFL. That's the reason why he's in the top 10 of carries so far this season.
Oh, I see what you're talking about. The guy came on the outside there.
Third
that
down
guy.
And one. Lynch is handed the football.
Yeah. Now, after this play, man, do that play action pass up the center, deep center.
Able to get it done that time.
First down, they'll never expect
it. He has the power and the will to make it happen. Third short, he just gets it done with sheer willpower.
First down here after the run.
Damn, they gave it to you. That's the first play they showed to you.
Stands in the pocket. Pass will be incomplete.
That's what's expected in the NFL nowadays from the players.
Trust me. They're too weak for it.
So athletic. They go all out for every catch. That time he just lets
well, you see how he's open in the center of the field, though, right?
Tebow's gonna take
just do that too late.
The Seahawks now move the chains.
You go in the center field all day now.
Great confidence in the receiver. And why not? He's talented. And every time the football's thrown his way, he finds a way to make the catch.
Get back in the run.
Tebow's completion percentage, 70% on the day.
Good job by the offense. And now they have a good sit.
Double tight end formation. The hit knocks the ball out incomplete.
Defense, play the situation. It's third long. Don't let him
receive it.
And make a catch to pick up the first down. Keep it in front of you. And then let him catch it and come up and make the tackle.
The Seahawks have to get to the 33 for a first. Comes away with it.
One of the better talented tight ends in the NFL. He makes that catch just right in stride.
Nice catch.
First down here after the completion.
He was wide open, too. I was watching the whole way, too. I know that's the route you were looking at.
Get a first down.
You just can't hide his talent. There's a reason why he's a top rusher in the NFL every single week. And even today, another good run, good vision.
He should just get right there sideline, man.
Pick up those big yards.
Yeah, I know.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play.
They're ready for it. They're ready for it.
Good job that time by the defensive player. He reads the quarterback, gets a position down near his own end zone, knocks that pass down.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends.
He had the
most going in the other direction.
It's a nice play that time by the defense.
The offense is inside your red zone. You got to stop them from scoring. That was a good job.
Oh, yeah.
He had the ball.
Yeah, he's crying, man.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Touchdown, Seattle Seahawks. He's caught his seventh touchdown pass of the season. Those points may have made the lead insurmountable, but just over a quarter to play.
What?
It's tough. Sometimes
touchdown?
In a situation like this, don't look at the scoreboard. Just think about going
just
out
so you know,
and executing one
I
play
did not
at a time.
Want to throw to him.
And you hope if you do that somewhere in the quarter,
you
can make it back
your triangle route.
Yeah, I was.
That slant route that you changed, you was watching that one. He was covering all fucking day.
Takes off from the five.
He was covered.
And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. The Seahawks defense, Phil, has been the driving force of this game from the start, and nothing has changed in the third quarter.
Well, they went into halftime, and they made no adjustments. They like what they saw. So what I
but
like
you
about
simulate next possession since you got
and that's just a great thing for a defense.
Got the lead now. You're up by 18.
Holding offense.
Damn, he got arm on.
That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. It's a two tight end formation. First down at the 18. The pass doesn't find a mark. Here's the handoff to Adrian Peterson.
Why the fuck would they do that?
It's third down coming. We'll send it back to the quarterback.
Oh, they will next quarter. They'll start throwing in shit once you get to fourth quarter. They change their whole strategy and everything.
They're in punting formation.
4th and 20. Let's go 4-20. Right.
Yeah, I saw that. I'm like, what?
Baldwin's gonna take this one from the 18. Holds in on the tackle. That return.
I know why I'm
20.
Hearing myself back this year.
Offense, defense, and special teams. What a play for the special teams here. Good punt return. Good blocking. They get it done.
The Seahawks obviously came up with a great message in the locker room at halftime, partner, as they have opened up the lead here with the third.
I love what they've done, Jim. They went into halftime, and they came up with some new formations. And those new formations have caught the defense by surprise. I guess you'd say he's like a quarterback. You can't complete them all. And this running back, he can't make every run.
Stop
tackler, nowhere to go. So only gets a couple yards this time.
Sorry, second down, nine. Got a great lead, man.
Robinson's able to read that play and make the hit. The Seahawks.
I let him hide the ball, man.
Continues some momentum, still possessing the football as the final quarter gets underway. They bring in the extra tight end.
At least he caught it. Take it off.
Final quarter underway now with this snap. Wants to go deep.
He watched that cross route.
Incomplete.
Well, that's not the worst thing that can happen to you in a situation like this. As long as the football was not intercepted, that's okay.
That's a bad idea. I did some stupid calls.
You was wide open with the first down, man, to rush it. And you threw it deep.
That punt sets up the defense now in excellent position as they're able to down the football inside the 10. The Vikings hope to get things going here. They have been anything but productive here in quite some time.
Three consecutive drives that have led to nowhere.
Well, let's give a lot of credit to the defensive side, especially the defensive line. They are absolutely taking it to the offense. They are beating them up, and the defensive line is winning the battles like this. It's all about the defense.
The Seahawks lead right now, and you look at how they played against the run today, and you have to see that this is a big factor why, Phil.
Yeah, they've done everything right to stop the running game, Jim. What have they done? They've shown a lot of toughness. They have good speed on the defensive side. They're aggressive, but most of all, they've shown tremendous discipline.
Second down and seven.
Well, if I was that quarterback, I'd be mad after getting sacked like that by the defensive end. Your offensive tackle's just got to do a better job.
Third down and must be extremely careful with
nice.
The
nice. The
Vikings
back.
Will line up. First down marker right at the 15-yard line. Out of the eye, it's Peterson.
What?
No, I didn't.
The Vikings trying to catch the defense by surprise here on third and long. They go with the run, and sometimes those runs on third and long work, and you can pick up a first down.
Yes, he's going forward to that point. I hate it. It's like that.
And it didn't work.
Looks like he fell back in the end zone.
Baldwin tackled down.
Well, only a couple yards that time by the punt returner.
Yeah,
good defense by the punt coverage team. They get down their speed. They hustle. They're all around him. They only give up a couple yards.
Damn,
two tight ends
murdered.
On the field here. And the immediate handoff to the
fullback. Super Steph got smacked. Hey, well, you got a great field position. That's nice going to pull back on that one.
Strong eye, handoff here. Good for only a yard. He's averaging
that's
about 4 yards
to
carry.
Pull back up again.
He's trying to be patient,
the
but
the
there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
After that last run, it sets up third and six.
Only a yard, damn.
Graham's there.
Oh, that was fucking close.
That's five receptions on the day.
That's an awesome job by the offense picking up this first down here in the second half. They've got a big lead. It's not about scoring.
Yeah,
it's
just
about
the
and that is an art. And this
team
is
good. Right through his hands
first down
again.
And 10. Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch. Gains 16. He's now pushed past 120 yards rushing today. Within 50 yards now of the single season rush.
He get out of the way. Damn, you can go.
Must he want to get it done here today?
Oh,
holy
of course
shit.
He wants to get it done today. That way he doesn't have to answer the questions. And when the game is over,
he can just ramp that all the way in.
What he has done, and that is a lot. The single season rush yards mark. That is incredible just to say what an accomplishment.
Oh, second. He should have glitched out of the ball.
Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap. And they hold that run to a short game.
No, I switched over to him.
Lined up. Empty backfield.
Are you lateral to him?
Cooper Helfen has it.
How did he see it? The feet's kind of blurry.
Defense, they really understand situational football. They know they're in the red zone. You can't give up plays. That time they give up completions. But they really took the football and keep it play to no gain.
And in his hands, complete.
After the strong flood, oh man, they ain't chasing them long cross routes.
Well, we've seen a lot of terrific passes by this quarterback today. Multiple touchdowns, showing his arm strength, showing his great touch. That's what you have to do to be a great quarterback in this league.
The Vikings have really just been outplayed in every facet
like
of this game.
He should have confetti in his hand.
Any sort of answer. The score is 35-10. It'll be a touchback.
He did the LeBron James. He needed baby powder.
The Seahawks defense forced the three and out the last series.
You know what they did? They went out there and whooped the offense. You know what I mean by whoop? That means you just dominate, and they did it.
The Seahawks with a nickel look here on defense. First down at the 20. Launching a deal.
Thank quarterback.
And they can't connect.
Do it.
Got to give this secondary credit. And this passing lane now, it's hard to make plays.
A
good play there and another incomplete pass.
Failing to complete that one.
Oh, so he dropped it. Oh. Oh, yeah, lucky left.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah, well, man to man.
The reception all alone.
That's second down and third down, yeah. It's going to do more cross routes because they're super fast.
That is a good job picking up the first down.
You see, he's going deeper down the field now, man. You got to watch him now. Fourth quarter is a different game, but
you play the game from there.
Bridgewater's completion percentage 60% on the day. First down at the 45.
Here goes to make that clock too.
Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands.
Gosh, if that was real life, that'd have been a
nice fucking
job
on the quarterback
right
finding the open guy short. They get the completion. They still do not get the first down though.
Second down coming up. Taken away the passing game, something they've struggled with all year, but not today, and that's why they're up in this one.
Yeah, they are taking away the passing game, like you said, and that's why they're winning,
because
they've made the offense
one dimensional. Each one of the wide receivers had their hand on the ball.
Out of the shotgun formation. Down the field. The Vikings
set the second down.
That's going to be right, one man. More play this Let's offense would like to have back today. But there have been probably more of those than we can count.
Yeah, it was a rough day. Nothing went well for them. You know, I thought the game plan was wrong for this team going against this defense. But, you know, the offense, they got some talent. You got to shake this off, practice hard next week, and hope you change things around.
The Vikings have focused on controlling the ground game all year, but today they've lost the battle, and that's a reason
just
why
your
they
time
on this
play
one.
Call it.
You know, sometimes stopping the run is just
about
the clock,
Jake.
Yeah,
the game.
It's just wanting to do it, and you need great willpower. They are not showing that so far today.
The Vikings pride themselves on their defense, but it hasn't been a strength for them here today.
Yeah, they do, but listen, it's not working today. They've been out there for a lot of plays,
and
you know what is
like
happening? They have fatigue, and when you have fatigue on the defensive side, what goes? You can't think clearly, and you just keep making bad mistakes.
First and 10. Out of the eye. Here's the handoff.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short game.
The Seahawks come out in a jumbo set. Second down and 7. And he's thrown to the ground. The defense pushing the offense back with that sack, and the offense needs 13 yards now on third down. Offense going to stop the game here with a timeout.
Shit.
It'll be third down. The Seahawks need to get to the 19 to pick up a first down. Rams gonna pull in the bullet pass.
Tick, 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 tick. That's what we're trying to do. Make that clock keep running down. You got the offense out there. You got a big lead in the second half. Every first down you get shortens that football game.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Send him Tebow,
this is a dangerous runner when you're giving room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
Tebow set, empty backfield. He'll take the snap from the gun. Over to Graham. Rams met after a gain of 8 and And as we get a better look at the numbers, here's a tight end who has done his best to make a huge impact the last couple of weeks, Phil.
Yeah, he's always determined, isn't he, Jim? You watch him play, he plays so hard. And when you do these type of things, the football just finds its way towards you.
Oh, man, he almost gets in the end zone so close to getting over the goal line.
Tick, tick, tick. I'm waiting.
Play clock's running down. Touchdown, Seahawks. That's touchdown number 5 for him in this game.
That was a nice job by the quarterback. He read the defense. He realized there was a little weakness in one spot. He goes there and gets the touchdown on the quarterback sneak.
Steven Hauschka ready for the kickoff. No return as this goes for a touchback. The Vikings counted on the passing game early, but it slowed down after a hot start. Bridgewater's tried to adjust to the defense, but it hasn't worked out.
Well, he's tried, but listen, there's nothing he can do about the offensive line. It's not been as sharp, but I'll tell you what, when an offensive line is not sharp, a quarterback's going to lose confidence.
And it's knocked down.
That was an incomplete pass that time against cover two, the two deep safeties, and you really want to throw the football down the middle or deep down the sidelines. That time the quarterback didn't do that, and that's why it was incomplete.
Second down and 10. Looking middle that time, and it's incomplete.
Third long situations, a lot of coordinators in this league will run a draw play on third long. Why? Because they're just looking for field position, pick up a few yards, and then by some miracle, if the running back's able to make guys miss, break some tackles, and pick up a first down, man, that's just gravy.
Third and 10. Wallace on the receiving end. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Nice job that time by the defense, knowing the situation. Go ahead and let the quarterback complete the pass. Just make sure you come up and make the tackle before the first down. Good job. Fourth down coming up.
Baldwin's tackled down at the 29.
The second time that's happened.
The Seahawks always count on their run game. They have one of the best backs in the league. Lynch is, of course, one of the best running backs in the NFL.
Well, what you do in the NFL, especially on the offensive side, you keep giving the football to your best players, and this running back is one of the best, and now he is starting to show.
Graham's got it on a pass, had some heat on it. 8th catch today so far. Graham's been the go-to tight end today, Phil, and really getting it done.
Yeah, if you want a great passing offense, you need a tight end who can really force the defense to cover him underneath and especially deep down the field. This tight end can do it all.
He's averaging about 4 yards a carry. That leads us to second down. Lynch lined up as the single back. Tebow's going to take off with it. Airtight coverage. Incomplete.
In a situation like this, third long, if you're the defense, catch them by surprise and blitz.
An extra tight end on the field for this one. Third down and 10. Gets the handles in.
The Seahawks decide to go for a run here on third long. And look, not second-guessing that play call, not hitting the playbook. In the passing game, they're going to pick up a first down. They go with the run, the defense is not fooled, and now they're going to have to punt.
All set to punt here.
Hey, you just simulate the rest of this game. You got it the bag you want.
That punt sets up the defense now in excellent position as they're able to down the football inside the 10.
The Vikings offense coming back onto the field here, desperately trying to avoid a repeat of their last drive when they had the quick three and out.
I'll tell you what, if they go three and out again, you know what's going to happen? Those defensive players are going to be looking at them as they come off the field. You put this back out there already, so it's important to get a drive, give your defense a little rest.
You need balance in the NFL. That's watching the game with you, and how about a final thought about that victory?
Well, you know, Jim, I wish I could say the same, that I enjoyed spending these last 3 hours with you, but that's just not the case. But no, just kidding, of course. Nice win. They got to feel good about what they've done and celebrate a little tonight.
I think I'll see you next week, maybe. So for Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.
Hey. I got the Ravens.
Damn. Yeah, I got the Falcons. Falcons, Giants, Falcons in Tampa Bay.
Spending my scouting points. What number are you on?
We don't know.
On the scouting.
What number am I on? Oh, what guy am I on? I got list though, man.
He won't be drafted. I send them all to 55. Should do do like a 50-50. Close your eyes after you start doing end of game. And then look at it when it's done. But when it comes to playoffs, I don't think we're going to skip it.
Goodbye. 55 to 45.
And I hope you say goodbye when the ask was a word for you to pay. For my music, for pressing play, for all the stress that went into my songs, my love. The most honest I could be with you.
Alrighty.
Yeah. Jeez. I would laugh if it was both 420. What? Really? Shit, is he injured? Is he injured? Dude, it's fine. Russell Wilson's out for the first playoff game, so my star quarterback. Yeah, I might use Tebow on the first playoff because he didn't do too bad. But, see, if you're going to bed, I'm just going to go head over to Slow Mo's party. Shit. Alrighty. Shit. Alright, well, I'll see you later, dude.